You remind me of my daughter.
Who are you?
I'm Stephen, your father's cousin. The one who invited you here, Loa.
How do you know my name?
I know many things. I know that you're not happy here. I know that you're sad and angry. You must feel very alone, but don't you? I know loneliness too.
My father is looking for you.
I see.
He has a gun.
I worry about his health. He seems troubled. Unwell. But you know that already, don't you? Come. Let's speak of happier things. Tell me. How do you like your necklace? One can hardly tell it was broken.
That was you.
Such a beautiful gift. Your mother has fine taste.
Had.
Has, child.
You knew my mother?
I know your mother.
My mother is dead.
No one's ever really dead. Would you like to see her?
Stay away from her.
Don't hurt him, Father!
No! Stephen! You look at me, you son of a bitch.
Find the book, cousin.
What's wrong with you?
You could still save your children.
You wanted me here. Well, I'm here. But you leave my family out of this.
Another man would be enjoying all this, but no private man like yourself, am I right?
Do you think he's staying warm outside?
I wouldn't have come myself, if not for her insistence, but she wanted to see him. And I want to be with her at every moment. It's strange, you know, I see her. And yet, I don't know how to describe it. It's unworldly. Does that make sense? Like every moment I'm with her seems impossible, yet there she is.
I told my bosses about all the good things happening here, and we're helping out with the fest.
That's fantastic.
Yeah. Nothing too crazy, just a little sponsorship to get the name out there, just in case good things happen.
Great news.
I've actually got a proposal to run by you, how you might be able to get us set up here, if you have time to talk later.
Absolutely. After the fest?
Yeah, where are you off to?
A couple of things to track down. I completely struck out with the junk guy down on 9.
Is that Abelard character? You know what? I'm chatting him up later. Might be able to sweet talk him for you.
Good luck with that.
When I was younger, I developed this obsession with medieval torture. Like the Judas Cradle. You ever hear of that?
No.
They sit you on this triangular metal point and you slowly become impaled. Or they strap you to the iron chair with hundreds of tiny little spikes. Or they tie you up in the town square and you die the slowest death imaginable on display for the whole town.
Nice. Why are you telling me this?
Because in 100 years, they'll look back at now and say that the most popular form of torture was refusing to let people die. Dragging it out. Give people false hope, false relief. Hook them up to machines, you know. Something that should take months to kill them would take years. Those people, they're the bad guys. You. You're one of the good ones.
You really think so?
Oh, yeah. Are you gonna stay with me?
Yes, of course I will.
Can you talk to me?
Me too, brother.
You know, Ross was never the sharpest knife in the drawer, but he never played me. You, on the other hand, I never fully trusted. And you, my friend, if you're gonna tell a story about a wife,
make sure you're wearing a wedding band.
Please don't.
Hey, I'm not a psychopath. I'm a realist.
Mama, let that boy play some rock and roll. Jazz is much too crazy. He can't play it when he's old. He's too young for the blues. He's still inside his first pair of shoes. He's just a baby. Give that boy some freedom, let him move around. Don't get in his way, you'll only bring him down. Mama, won't you let him play some rock and roll. Yeah. Let him play some rock and roll. Let him play some rock and roll. Let him play some rock and roll. Young.